What's going on, everybody? Back like we never left. Got one more package in the mail. I think this makes number 7. And put everything in a place I probably shouldn't have. I actually put it in one of my boxes. I think it's a 5,000 count box for storing Pokemon cards. So I put some of the packs in there and they actually fit quite well. I was not expecting them to be so nice looking inside the new home. So I think for a while I'm just going to let them be. It looks quite nice. Might make a video about it. But yeah. Shout out to wherever I got this from. Knocked out pretty well. Not cracked at all. This is another Darkness Ablaze. I am excited to have this pack. I was wondering what the other pack was, but Darkness Ablaze, I think I liked it so much that I ordered two cases. That is pretty much it. I might actually show my little housing system I have right now for little packs of 10. See, it's already cut. That booger is not going down easy. I know there's levels to some of the other plastic I pulled, once you pulled on it, it just tore all the way off. This one did not. It was hugging for its dear life. As you guys know, Darkness Ablaze is one of my favorite packs to pull from. The results speak for themselves, and hopefully it keeps up that trend so it can stay my favorite, or at least one of them. And I set all of this off to the side for one memento. I actually get this storage out. So I can show you guys how it looks. Got some chilling rain lying around just waiting to be open. Is what I have on my pack set at the moment. Like I said, I love the way they fit in there, and whenever I get a new pack, I believe Darkness Ablaze goes right in there. Take the team ups and slide them to a different area. And the team ups. So these over here, there's just a little bit of everything. Let's put the team ups right here with the battle stuff. This thing holds 5,000 individual cards. Of course, it's not going to hold 5,000 packs, but it holds quite a bit. And I'm kind of excited to fill it up with packs. So that might be a secret goal I have right now. Not 100% sure, but I am digging what we got going on right now. So with the celebrations, I feel like they'll be worth a lot more unopened 25 to 50 years from now. And the same thing could probably be said for all of these because they're old-ish. There's a lot of thunder. Burning shadows. Evolution. Just pulled a champion's path. Ultra Prism. Darkness Ablaze. I think we threw a team up in there. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure we did not get a battle stuff. Alright, now let's see what we have. Ultra Prism Battle Styles. That is one of every pack except if we're being literal, except for champions. And come in. There you go. That'd be 12 right there. So slide all of that over. And 12 different packs. 12 different series. I'm not sure how many series Pokemon have. I know this is not all of them right here in front of me, though. I stopped keeping track of all that stuff. But without further ado, let me get these handy dandy scissors. Let's dive into some of these packs. What time is it? 11:04, so I guess I can say it again. Happy birthday to my girlfriend. I hope you had a good day today. You know, some of my other friends did with their, partying. Blissy with the glizzy. GX. So pin in the middle. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's a wrinkle right there in the middle of the card. Definitely brings the value of the card down a little bit. Luckily, I'm just collecting these. And I'm pretty sure I'll get another one. Much better condition. And that was from the Lost Thunder. Thank you. Thank you, Pat, for your contribution. It's my very first champion's pass. Our very first champion pass on the channel. And Tilly, and I think I already have this card. I'm not 100% sure. It's looking good though. I'm feeling the finger point. Letting everybody know. Pocket Monster Breeder Nurturing. Shout out. We got a VMAX. I've definitely seen you on the cover a couple of times. Gunfar. Trubbish. Alright, that is the last one. I'm not mad at that. That was a Champion's Path pack. Darkness Ablaze. Let's see if you can hold it down like you normally do. I have a lot of Butterfree VMAXs. Broken bonds. Almost got that. Now onto the unbroken bonds. Also one of my favorite packs to pull from. Usually has some amazing pull rates and some amazing cards. Don't let me down, baby. Butterfree. Last but not least, set out Metal Metal. All right, team up. I'm not sure if this is the first. I think so. Drew in a while. Moltres, shut up. That's a normal card, but oh yeah, it's been a while since we've seen your type. And Jinx. Looking how she's looking. That's a cool looking card. Like some origami. Sun and Moon, Burning Shadows this time. All right, here we have some extremely, well, let's just say no yellow. I was about to say extremely close lines, but no yellow showing on these. Sexy. my favorite EV evolution, personally. Burning Shadows. I guess we'll just go up and over. Chilling rain. See what you can add to this already amazing party. This is a part of somebody dies. All right, that is pretty much normal from Chilling Rain. Whole lot of nothing. Pack still look good. All right, let's do the celebrations last. Evolutions, you are up. Shout out, Blastoise Spirit Link out of the pack. I got a Fat Boy Pikachu. Mewtwo with a lot of damage. Hopefully that's not $1 million card, which, to my understanding, fresh out of the pack, not graded, there are $1 million cards. Alright, so the trainer card is the big one in that particular evolutions pack. On to the next. Ultra Prism. Another first. Even though I'm pretty sure I pulled an Ultra Prism pack out of one of my tens. I say it's a first as far as opening. First of many packs to come, let's say that. Alright, no card tricks necessary. Let's just spin and get it in. Wow, that is a weird card. This is a little lawnmower Pokemon. I remember Execute. I've never saw an Executor with a long, long neck like that. An Ultra Ball. Not mad at that. Alright, Battle Styles. So if we wanted to, we can definitely call this a Mega Versus. This is pretty much one of everything I have in stock. One more Pika, holding it down for the 99 and the 2000s. I definitely already have you, little buddy, but VMAX is always welcome. Leaf Energy, Tower of Waters. And come here. Yeah. Okay. This one definitely has a little bend in it. But it's not ultra rare or anything, so no worries. And second to last is our Evolving Skies. Also the second newest pack. The last one being the newest packs that we will be opening. Look tasty. Appleton. Pyroar. Alright, that is typical Evolving Skies. Nothing new there. And last but not least, the newest packs that I currently possess celebrations. All the cards are very, very low in value, which I don't really understand, but hey, I do not make Pokemon cards. Like I said, this will be way, way, way more money, way, way later in time. So, you know, 25, 50 years from now, these will be worth a lot. Just like all Pokemon, right? Lugia, looking, looking nice. I can't remember which ones I need at the moment, so let's just get through this. Palkia. Dark Gyarados looks amazing, though. Look at the detail in that. Might only be worth a couple of cents, but it looks amazing. Shout out. And the Mew. So we actually have quite a few cards to go over, and no, they're not put into a top loader or a sleeve at the moment. Didn't actually have time, even though I could have paused and did so. Didn't actually feel like it. So yeah. Watching this video, let me think what you think. What card you think is the most expensive or coolest looking? In your own opinion, of course. Now, if you know which one is the most expensive, feel free to tell me, because a lot of times I'm just opening the cards because I love Pokemon cards. Not actually looking for a high pull or anything like that. It's just all part of the experience, really. Like I always say, if I should have been jumping out of my chair, you know, just let me know. Sometimes I'm ignorant to the fact as well. But you guys have a beautiful night. I'm out. Keep it G like me. I'll let you boy.